Angry parents are turning up the heat on the O'Farrell government over its failure to remove toxic gas heaters from classrooms. They say the delay is putting their kids' health at risk.
Furious parents joined a statewide protest turning off school heaters and using blankets to draw attention to the dangers of unflued gas heaters in public schools.
It's not considered a cold climate school here, even though we had sleet and snow earlier this week. And to be honest, I would rather have my daughter here wrapped in a blanket than in the classroom with the unflued, unsafe gas heating.
The heaters emit carbon dioxide, formaldehyde and nitrogen dioxide directly into classrooms.
And everybody knows the heaters are causing health issues, and it's time for the government to put a plan in place and let us know when they're going to fix the problem.
Only 100 schools have had heaters replaced. A full replacement program could cost $400 million.
Unflued gas heaters, if used properly, are perfectly safe. So I think it's important that parents and schools understand that, but there is a commitment to replace them over time, and that will happen.
This government, when they were in opposition, said very clearly they wanted to get rid of them. Now they're in government, they're not doing anything about it.
But parents say they'll continue to fight for classrooms free from toxic pollutants.
The Asthma Foundation says unflued gas heaters pose such a health risk, they should also be removed from homes.
Everybody's vulnerable, but particularly those people who do tend to spend large amounts of time indoors at home, pregnant women, parents and their young children.
John Hill, 10 News.